times are stoking anti-immigrant fervor, and high unemployment is putting pressure on politicians to create jobs any way they can, even if it means demonizing the migrant workforce that American farmers depend on. North American correspondent Jane Cowan reports from the heart of Dixie.
It could be any community anywhere. But here in Alabama, even this familiar ritual has been imbued with anxiety.
When the law passed, as in the governor signed it, a person on the street left the St. Pete with a red truck full of everything that he owned, just up and left. You had students in South Alabama who go to school crying because they wouldn't have the parents if they got back.
Victor Palafox came here as a six-year-old child, crossing through the Rio Grande River from Mexico. His family is part of an estimated 120,000 undocumented immigrants now living in Alabama.
Siete años atrás.
The last time I saw my sister was